नमस्ते। टुडे वी विल सी हाउ आवर वेरियस इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स आर कनेक्टेड विद आवर इमोशंस। दिस इज एज पर ट्रेडिशनल चाइनीज मेडिसिन एंड इट इज वेरी कॉमनली यूज्ड नोन थिंग इन ट्रेडिशनल मेडिसिन एस्पेशली द चाइनीज। सो देर आर emotions that are linked with the organs of your body. For example, the number one emotion will be fear, and it's also a basic one. So it is a very common one, it's a very basic emotion, and that is fear. So the organ that is linked with fear is your kidneys and your adrenal gland. So whenever there is fear, the adrenal makes you to turn to the sympathetic nervous system, and that is the fight and flight mode. So your whole body chemistry changes according to the emotion. So suppose you are afraid, you are in fear of something about your future. It may be even a small thing about an interview, about your future, or something that you are imagining that it's going to happen. It's not that it should be a real fear. Even the imagination, even the thought, even the movies like horror movies, or the news channels, or like when you see some news that creates an inner fear of violence or crime. So all these things can waste a lot of energy from your kidney and adrenal gland. So fear is connected to kidney. So remember that whenever you watch a horror movie or any news channel and you're afraid of something that is happening, don't get attached to the TV. Just keep distance between your real life, and don't make allow the outer circumstances to influence you. So there are two ways of watching a movie. One is you can get into the movie and become very emotional. Another is you always remember that it's just a movie, so you don't start crying when something happens to the hero or heroine. So the whole art is about keeping a distance between the situation and your real life so that it doesn't affect you, because constant fear will can be very damaging to your kidneys and adrenal gland and to the nervous system. So it will weaken the nervous system, because constantly if you're on the fight and flight mode, then the body will not be able to do the proper digestion, do proper rest, relaxation, or the immunity will be very low, and any repair work that is to be done in the body, any regeneration of cells will be postponed. So too much of postponing, and if you're too much in the fight and flight mode, then physically and mentally it can be very challenging. In nature, the fight and flight mode is to be used only when there is an unfortunate circumstance, like you're being attacked by some animal, or you have come across a snake or something. So that is the time when the adrenal gives you a lot of strength to the muscles. When it gives lots of strength to the muscle, it is either to fight with the animal or to run from the situation to save yourself. And when that circumstance is over, you need to just relax and cool down, so that again the system will get okay with the situation, and again your digestion and other normal activities of the body will take energy. If it is on the fight and flight mode, then it will not digest your food properly, and this may create a lot of problem. Because constantly if you see our normal day-to-day life, even in a traffic jam, or when you meet your boss, or when you're late to the office, or when you're speaking to your friends or related to business, various circumstances, you're very, very stressful and you're actually on the fight and flight mode and you're using